devoted somehow the similar subject as Gabo's talk, to some aspect of neutron stars. The name of the talk is Compact Stars, Dipole Magnetic Field on the Background of Hadron Space and Geometry. So the talk is devoted to calculation of Maxwell's equation in such space geometry. The talk is organized by such way. At the first, I will make a very short description of the space-time geometry, Hadron space-time geometry, because the details was given in the talk of Martin Ubrantz in the Monday. Then, I will show the method how we solved the Maxwell equation in such space-time background and for aligned magnetic dipole field. And then I will show perturbative expansion of full potential of the field. And then I will show some really preliminary result, the field, magnetic field, and the induced electric field for static observers at infinity and for the local Kapitan orbiting observers. So the Hartleton space-time geometry is exact solution of Einstein equation describing space-time in the vicinity of the perfect fully stationary axisymmetric and solid rotating star or body. The space-time is only three parameters. So three parameters, mass, specific angular momentum, and dimensionless quadruple momentum Q, describing the oblateness of the star. So the element is given by the standard wave for axisymmetric space-times, and the coefficients of the metric with accuracy up to quadratic terms in J is given as a perturbation of the Schwarzschild metric plus some diagonal terms describing the rotation of the space-time and the central body. The quadruple moment Q is cut in the J square, so really working in the quadratic accuracy of the metric coefficients. So, in this slide, we can show the form of the potential. The potential is only two terms, the time component and the azimuthal component. And the components are a function of the r and theta. So, this is necessary for axial symmetry of the field, and using the Maxwell equation, we arrive in such system of two Maxwell equations for the components, and it's very easy to calculate the component of the field, magnetic and electric field, in the Zamo frame, and the necessary ingredient of solution is junction condition of the surface of the star. We are assuming the star with superconducting interior and magnetic field lines are frozen in the surface of the star. So the observers, which is sitting on the surface of the stars, don't feel no electric fields. So there is no Lorentz force. This is the last condition. Necessary condition for solving such equations, system of equations. So the system equation is not so easy to solve, but we know the solution in more simple situation in the Lenz string space-time geometry. Space-time geometry, which is given by Redzo et al. For arbitrary inclined dipole. And the solution for case with dipole with zero inclination is reduced into simple form. Simple form which Schwarzschildian azimuthal component of full potential and new, with respect to Schwarzschildian case, time component of full potential given by such term. And of course, we have to fix such functions we respect the junction commissioner regularly to infinity. And finally, we arrive in the final perturbation expansion in the Lenstrain case, the azimuthal component as only absolute term, and in case of non-charged stars, the time component has only linear term in J. So this is known solution in Lenstrain spacetime, and the solution was independently found by Kone and Kojima. And in the Hartle-Torn case, we can complete or add new perturbation term in the previous perturbation expansion, quadratic terms in J and linear in Q, but it's still the quadratic in J. And we arrive in the six Maxwell equations, somehow not so simple system. But the situation is not so bad, because because we can draw some diagram or plot of hierarchy of dependencies of such perturbation term or corresponding equations, and we'll see that the nonlinear term of time component is not connected to magnetic field on the surface, and in fact the solution has some gauge freedom, so we are working with some arbitrary component of potentials. And of course the most simplest or the physically meaningful way how to set such components is set it to zero. So zero because the Maxwell equation will be fulfilled and we obtain solution which is not, which is really connected for the junction condition of the surface of the star. This is what we want, of course. And with such assumptions, so the final perturbation expansion can be done in such form as the time component will be still the same as in the Lenstrain spacetime, and we have two new components, nonlinear in J. In the azimuthal part of the four potential, and of course by solving proper order level equations, you obtain the final solution, and again the constants or functions A will be given by the conditions of regularity at infinity and the junction condition of the surface of the star, and of course the solution so long, it's about two slides. I don't want to show it, but it's only some function of R and theta. What I would like to show is some result or some test or model field for some model of neutron stars, which has such parameter. The parameter is based on the Martin Van Stolk. On Monday, we have neutron stars with two solar masses, with such GMQ and such corresponding frequencies for such values. So we have, in effect, there is some linear relation between G and Q, and reduces the element kilometers, which correspond to 3.77 m. And what we need to fix magnetic field is the magnetic field essential on the surface. We choose the value 1000 Tesla. And using the Lorentz boost, it's very simple to obtain from the components in Zamo frame. arrive on the field, on the magnetic field for the arbitrary rotating observers, using only difference between the angular velocities of the ZAMO observer and the observer for which we calculating the component of the field. And this is the result for static observer at infinity. This is the component of the field induced by the rotation and the frame dragging. And we can observe a very interesting effect that we have some line which corresponds to zero value of intensity electric field. On the left side, towards the surface of the star, we have some negative intensity, and on the opposite side we can observe the positive is lines. So this is interesting, and only induced by the frame dragging and rotation and the form of the solution in natural torus space-time. Now we can observe or see the magnetic field. There is no some special effect, but on the right side, this is deviation from the Lenz-string solution. And we can see that the deviation is in order 10. This is no big difference for magnetic field in the Lenz-string. It's based on description, Hartleton description for the static observers. But situation is a bit different for the Keplerian local Keplerian observers sitting on the accretion disk. At the first, because of properties of Pusse matrix, there is some deviation not only for the magnetic field, but for electric field, because we have J square and Q terms in the Pusse matrix, so there is some deviation with respect to Lenz-string case, and we can observe that the differences between Lenz-string and Hartle-Torn magnetic field is in order up to 1 to 10, maybe. And of course, there is ISCO line, and the values under the ISCO is has no physical meaning, of course. This is only a result of formal calculation. So, I have no conclusion, but I have plans for the future. At the first, I would like to find or compute perturbation expansion for dipole field with arbitrary equation in the Hartle-Torn space-time geometry. And we would like to make analysis of charge metal orbital motion in such field. Yeah, thank you.